You know, I've never mentioned my love for pure comedy. It's not like I'm an aspiring comedian that goes to amateur nights and performs, but I like to think that I know comedy well enough to judge it. My favorite comedians are George Carlin, Steve Martin, then there are the comedies of David and Jerry Seinfeld, Chris Rock, for you, Jamie Foxx, Chappelle, Always Sunny in Philly. There's too much. Now here are my favorites for purely comedy anime: Great Teacher Onizuka, Detroit Metal City, Cromartie High School, Sayonara, Penny and Stocking. Others that I can say are probably close to being up to the favorites are One Punch Man, Gintama, from what I've seen. Everything else just hasn't tickled my funny bone. Not Konosuba, not Sakamoto, they're just not funny to me. I mean, there are things I straight up have never seen, like Nichijou or Mob Psycho 100, but I've seen enough of anime comedies to understand that they suck. They're either random equals funny like Aho Girl, blue material comedy like Prison School or Golden Boy, wholly referential like Pop Team Epic, and especially lots of these comedies are plagued with edgy humor, some being only edgy like Ghost Stories.
Down! Drop the Krispy Kreme, Serpico! We need your help here!
People in my house look like my father and my brother after
nightmares are just diggity-diggity-diggity-diggity-diggity-diggity-diggity-diggity!
But he... What? Ketura, what, are you retarded? Obviously. Which way did he go?
You're such brave, strong, handsome men. Have you accepted Jesus as your personal savior?
No, I'm Jewish.
Oh, perfect. It's in Japanese. Jingchao no ning tao. Wait, that's Chinese. Luckily, I can read Barricade.
When this bitch kicks, I'm moving to Vegas.
I think that's the biggest issue with anime. It likes unsafe jokes because people don't expect it and therefore laugh. This is even a thing outside of anime. Someone once told me that they love edgy humor because it's different from the usual comedy like Seinfeld. Now this sort of triggered me because I see edgy comedy and jokes everywhere. The kind of Seinfeld humor, or to be specific, observational humor, is rare to find these days. And in anime, it doesn't even exist. And I hope that's a good enough thesis for me to transition into a recent comedy that is observational humor. An actual breath of fresh air, as opposed to some of these subversive comedies. Middle Manager Tonegawa sets itself apart right off the bat. As I'm sure everyone who's seen Middle Manager Tonegawa has also seen Kaiji, I'll be brief. In the anime, we see how Kaiji attempts to win each match, usually thinking of strategies to best the opponent. Eventually, he reaches Tonegawa, a snake that stands in Kaiji's path. Tonegawa thus far in the anime had been the real enemy, and also the first person who wasn't a loser. The match between Kaiji and Tonegawa came to one thing: the difference in the talented and the moronic. The only way for Kaiji to beat Tonegawa was to outwit him. You know how he does that? By splattering blood marking the slave, and then playing it after a fake switch. And the best thing about it? It was all Tonegawa. He was first rate to notice the bloodstain marking. And because Kaiji knew that Tonegawa was observant, he played it to his advantage. What made Kaiji so good is what makes Tonegawa just as good. It's a cerebral game, and Tonegawa is too observant. A comedy with this kind of character would inevitably contain some observational humor. Tonegawa is just too keen for his own good. This is evident in episode 2 when Tonegawa analyzes Chairman Hyodo's face for feedback. He believes that Hyodo is bored with the ideas from the black suits, but really, Hyodo is just an old man who needs his nap time. By erasing all the ideas to indemnify himself, he's distanced himself from the black suits for nothing. And that's just one of the scenes we see of Tonegawa being too sharp. On episode 1, Tonegawa struggles remembering the name of his black suits. One of them he encounters is named Kawasaki, but because of his intelligence, he realized that the first black suit was named Yamazaki, and their names ended the same. The narrator even says, "It's possible that if he hadn't noticed the similarity, he may have been able to memorize both with ease." It's these really psychological and relatable issues Tonegawa has that I'm delighted to see. I especially love humor that is subtle. On episode 1, we're able to see how acute Tonegawa is to everything. Even his diet, which we can see from this scene of him drinking out of a juice box that includes one day's worth of vegetables. It not only tells us that Tonegawa is a mindful eater, but that he takes himself too seriously to realize that he's a grown man drinking from a juice box to get his required amount of nutrients for the day. Here's another great one. After successfully getting to know all the black suits, you'd expect Tonegawa to now be good at names. But he's still the same. On episode 4, Tonegawa calls the whiteboard dude Tone, which is the mahjong tile on his shirt. It's even funnier when one of the men in black call him Tone as well. I think what's best in Middle Manager Tonegawa is specifically how seriously it takes itself. A good comedy that uses absurdity is key and peele. You'll realize that most of the episodes revolve around things that are mostly realistic, and they continue to push into ridiculousness. Episodes like Flicker or Boarding Order are great examples of this. In fact, some episodes are purely realistic, but still absurd enough to not happen. Examples of these episodes would be Country Music or even Turbulence. You may ask what makes absurdist humor different from Random Equals Funny, and to that I bring you this explanation. Random Equals Funny was a movement in memes and comedy where people said random things and people found them funny. It was immediately called out, and you won't find people ever saying random equals funny and mean it. The thing about absurdist humor that makes it humorous is that it has a starting point and devolves into craziness. It's when things that are illogical in the premise aren't taken into account that make the scene funny. And what's more is that the premise is taken completely seriously. An example of this would be episode 21 of Cromartie High School. On a bullet train to a school field trip, a group of juveniles form a long line to get into the bathroom. The man occupying the restroom is our main character, Kamiyama. As soon as he gets out, the line becomes a crowd of people pushing and shoving to get into the restroom. Kamiyama proposes an idea to the crowd by saying he has an idea that is fair to everyone. Because no one wants to fight and end up barfing or pooping, they all listen to Kamiyama. Kamiyama's idea is simple. Everyone puts their name on a paper, and he draws lots to determine who gets to use the bathroom. Kamiyama reassures everyone that this is fair before drawing a person's name, and because of the pressure in the environment, the person chosen will go no matter what. That person is Kamiyama. This scene is a great example of absurdist humor because the premise is clear, and it gets exploited because there should have been a system put in place that wouldn't allow him to go twice. The issue that wasn't taken into account was double counting. One quick fix I can think of would be to just take Kamiyama's name off the paper. As I said before, the premise is taken completely seriously. So why is this related to Middle Manager Tonegawa? Well, because Tonegawa has mild absurdism. On episode 5, Tonegawa and the group must propose the idea of restricted rock, paper, scissors. But to do that, they want to propose the idea to Chairman Hyodo when he's in a good mood. According to one of the black suits, you can tell Hyodo is happy or angry by the angle of his eyebrows. So when Tonegawa goes to check on Hyodo the only time of the day he's happy, he's greeted with this. His plan relies on eyebrows more than Hyodo's mood, and what wasn't taken into account was that he'd be wearing a face mask. Another good example is how Tonegawa miscalculated Ebitani's surprise in his venue proposal for inspiration on episode 6. If I were to mention one final thing that's funny about Middle Manager Tonegawa, it would be that it has visual comedy like none other. And that's because it borrows from its main source, Kaiji. Those metaphors that Kaiji uses to exaggerate the scene to be more suspenseful can now be seen being used to make these sort of lowbrow jokes. Examples of that would be episode 1 where Tonegawa compares the black suits to gutter balls, using their hobbies as a way to roast them and show that visually. All the segments always leave in a sort of exaggerated metaphor. For instance, episode 4 includes a scene where Tonegawa is literally holding onto a spider's web, which we find out to be Chairman Hyodo's jewel after he fails. From the inherent nature of Tonegawa being observational, to seeing some of its subtle humor that's different from other in-your-face comedies, to even seeing some well-executed visual comedy, it's clear to see that Middle Manager Tonegawa sets itself apart from other comedies in all the right ways. And because of these attributes Tonegawa has, it was sculpted from a great series and had a good head start in being a great pure comedy. And plus, I feel the need to say this, but I feel there is some progression with Tonegawa as opposed to other comedies. You always get the feeling that Tonegawa is getting to really know his employees, and it's simply because it has some very genuine moments, such as Tonegawa abandoning his idea, or even helping Ebitani out. Sure, they make a few jokes about it, but you can't take back the sincere moments. It's like traumatizing someone and then telling them it's a prank. The damage is already done and can't be recovered just like that. I hope this overly long, gushing analysis explained why I believe that Middle Manager Tonegawa is the best comedy out right now. Hey, if you want to encourage my strange behavior of making long videos of things that nobody watches, smash that like button and subscribe.